Hey folks, I'm here in the kitchen. Let's get technical. What do you think will happen if I put this marshmallow into that microwave? Let's do the experiment, and you can do it too if you want. All you need is a marshmallow, something to put the marshmallow on, like say a paper towel, and a microwave. Let's go ahead and pop the marshmallow into the microwave for 30 seconds and see what happens. Whoa! Look at that, that's crazy. We just put a measly little marshmallow in the microwave and it blew up to like twice its size, if not more. But what I wanna do today is, whoa, look at that. Now the marshmallow is shrinking again. What's going on here? Let's head back to the studio. To understand how this works, we have to understand microwaves, how heat transfers, and Charles's law. Let's start with microwaves. What are they? And they're not this. I mean, they are, but not in this case. Microwaves are part of this thing, the electromagnetic spectrum. The electromagnetic spectrum is, well, a spectrum of all the frequencies of electromagnetic waves. Along with microwaves, this includes stuff like X-rays, radio waves, and most notably, visible light. Electromagnetic waves are, unsurprisingly, made up of an electric field and a magnetic field. Now, these fields are constantly oscillating or changing direction, and those waves change direction quite a lot, up to 2.45 billion times a second. Wow. Okay, now let's see what happens when we mix those microwaves with the marshmallow. Marshmallows are pretty much made up of sugar, water, and air. Air is specifically important. In a marshmallow, there are a ton of these little air pockets or air bubbles. This gives them that nice squishy feel. Microwaves specifically target this, a water molecule. Water, as you probably know, is made up of two hydrogen atoms and one oxygen atom, hence H2O. Water has a positively charged end, the hydrogen, and a negatively charged end, the oxygen. So like I said before, those electromagnetic waves have a magnetic field which is changing direction and moving back and forth really, really quickly. Now, because the water molecule is magnetically attracted to the field, the magnetic field oscillating causes the water to start oscillating, shaking, and jiggling. Heat is a measure of the average kinetic energy of a sample. What that basically means is the faster a particle is moving, the more kinetic energy the particle has, and the hotter the particle is. The electromagnetic field changes direction, and the water molecule oscillates with that magnetic field. That makes the water molecule jiggle super fast. It has more kinetic energy, and the water molecule gets hot. Side note here, this is why microwaves can be really bad for humans. If you encounter a lot of them, then they make all the water molecules in your body get hot, and you don't want to do that because most of your body is made up of water. So that would not be good. But don't worry, microwaves, the kitchen tools, are completely safe. They've got plenty of insulation to make sure that those harmful waves don't get out. That's why you can't receive a phone call if your phone is in the microwave. Phone calls use radio waves, and microwaves are built to keep waves like that out. And with that, let's take a look at how heat transfers. Just as an example here, let's say we have one water molecule, H2O, and one oxygen molecule, O2. H2O is moving and jiggling way faster, and O2 is jiggling a bit slower. Because they're both moving, they're both flying around all over the place, and they end up bouncing off each other. This is when the heat slash thermal energy transfer happens. The water molecule bumps into the oxygen molecule, causing the water molecule to slow down and lose kinetic energy, which makes it be cooler. The reverse happens to the oxygen molecule. Once the water molecule bumps into it, the oxygen molecule speeds up and gains kinetic energy, making it hotter. This is exactly what happens when you pop that marshmallow in the microwave. The water molecules, jiggling very, very fast because they're magnetically moved by the electromagnetic wave, bump into the air molecules in the air pockets that make up the marshmallow, making those air molecules fly around faster. And because all of those air molecules are flying around, they push the boundaries of the air pockets they're in. Since in every air pocket there are a ton of air molecules literally bouncing off the walls, the marshmallow gets bigger and bigger, and consequently less and less dense. This also explains why the marshmallow shrinks when we take it out of the microwave. The air in the air bubbles becomes cool again, meaning they're no longer pushing against the walls. The molecules are getting colder, slowing down, and the bubbles deflate. This, my friends, is a prime example of the gas law, Charles's law. And no, that doesn't refer to Charles Boyle. Though, I kid you not, there is also a gas law called Boyle's law, so Charles's law states that when the temperature of a gas increases, the volume also increases, assuming pressure is constant. The temperature of the air in the air pockets in the marshmallow increases, so the volume of those air pockets, and subsequently the volume of the marshmallow as a whole, increases. And that's just about it. But before I sign off, there's just one more thing I gotta do. Chubby Bunny.
Chubby Bunny. Chubby Bunny. Chubby Bunny.